Oh, hey.
Hey.
What you doing here? I mean, I'm real glad you're here. Come here.
I can't stay.
What's up, babe?
But it's Lamar.
What that fool want now?
It's your best friend. He's your best fucking friend.
For real. My best friend. My homeboy, right? My nigga. Man, fuck you. I mean, not like that, man. But no, he ain't. He just another nigga from the hood. Him, Stretch, and all the motherfucking clowns. All he wanna do is drag a motherfucker down and live in the past.
And this is the future? A big empty house with nobody who gives a fuck about you. Oh,
shit, it works for me, it can work for you, babe.
I'm getting married, Franklin, to a doctor, not a murderer.
Then what the fuck you doing here, Tanisha?
I'm worried about Lamar, you gotta help him, Franklin.
Man, that shit is over.
Oh, I'm a legitimate businessman now, sister. I'm a CEO, an investor. I'm a Illuminati, I'm a fucking moron, nigga. You a phony fuck.
What?
I ain't saying you gotta marry the fool. I'm saying he's about to get killed over that deal you and him put on with... Stretcher set him up.
Fuck, man. My whole fucking life I've been looking after this motherfucking, paying the price afterwards. Fuck.
Well, at least do it one more time, Franklin, for me.
For you? For you and your doctor?
I love you and Lamar. We grew up together, but this life ain't for me, and you knew that. You ain't changing. I don't care how many cars you own, how many apartments you own, I don't care how many diamonds you put in your ear. It ain't for me, not done bad or done good.
Babe, look, I'll change.
No, you won't, and that's fair enough, but at least respect what you do, who you are. If you let that idiot die, you a bigger asshole than I thought. Look, he's going up to some sawmill near Polito Bay. Ugh, you do what you gotta do.
Franklin, what's up?
Hey, man, I'm in a bit of a bad situation. My boy Lamar got set up. I think he up near Polito Bay at some sawmill with some ballers. Could you, like, do some computer magic and look into it? Is that possible at all?
Should be. I've got a back door into the Polito Bay police network left over from the score we did up there. Give me a second here. Hold on. Yes.
So what it say?
Huh. This must be it. There are older reports of a weed operation being run by an African-American gang. The files got buried, so I'm guessing they paid off the cops.
They growing weed up there?
Growing it in the hills, most likely, but they might be packing and shipping it out of this sawmill. I'd expect a fair few of them up there.
Shit. And I'm gonna need some help. Can you tell Mike and Trevor to meet me up there?
They still aren't getting along that well.
Tell them it's for me, and it's serious. Thanks, man.
Tunnel straight to Mexico. Pass me my strap, I think the police at my door, because I'm still living like a dope dealer. Finger on the trigger, I ain't taking shit from no nigga. Still living like a dope boy, wrapping up a bag of drug trapping with your note, boy. Still living like a dope dealer.
Let's support single moms out there. Make sure you visit your local strip club.
Still living like a dope boy.
We're proving that Los Santos is more than just traffic jams full of people trying to escape town, man. Movie stars walking little tiny dogs so they can be photographed, and fast food restaurants next to yoga studios. Radio Los Santos, we've been doing this for years.
Weasel News.
Terror at the airport.
Men love it, monkeys do it, and masturbating has now won fame or shame.
I find 3D street maps include upskirt shots with paid advertising.
War on Terror.
A frightening scene at Los Santos International. Reports say there are multiple casualties and millions of dollars of damage. Terrified travelers fled for their lives as a high-speed chase across the runway involving police and unknown assailants left a trail of destruction in its path. This traveler was sympathetic.
I don't care who died. My flight's delayed now.
Ratings were improved for the recent season finale of Fame or Shame and the stunning upset by three of our closest cousins who spanked it into the history books. Despite a last-minute attempt by Tracy DeSanta to sing her way to the title with a great performance Freudians love, the monkeys wagged their way into America's heart as they had done all season.
Technology News. News.
iFind is literally going for the money shot with a new feature that takes upskirt photos, puts them online, and sells advertising. Residents were mixed on the new service.
I'm glad my wife's private parts are generating money for iFind. It's nice I can log on and see her secret places anytime.
Weasel News, confirming your prejudices.
The hottest hip hop with the king of Los Santos Radio. Big Boy, it's 106.1 Radio Los Santos.
Tell him, slow down. No, you can't catch me. I'm on too fast on the gas. Don't chase me. Slow down. Slow down. Tell him, slow down. No, you can't catch me. I'm on too fast on the gas. Don't chase me. Slow down. Slow down.
Like this stoolie, huh? We want Lamar to be rescued, not sold to the feds.
Give it a rest, asswipe.
Man, will y'all two shut the fuck up? Now let's take a look at this place, man. Lester said this was some type of big weed store spot.
Place is crawling with ballers, you know? Now me and you, we don't mind the old gang warfare, but Suede Bucks over there...
Yeah, tell Trevor I said bite me.
Man, I said shut up. Now I see the weed, but where the fuck is Lamar? Oh, shit, there he go.
You know what? Tell Trevor I'm gonna be up on this hill with my rifle. I don't want to be anywhere around him when he fucks this whole thing up.
Classic. Classic, huh? He's already planning his escape. Oh, fuck.
I'm gonna find a way in.
I saw a few possible entry points when I got here. One, the front entrance on the right there. It's the most direct way in and most likely the heaviest. Two, down the hill to my left. There's a bulldozer there. Might be able to use it in the assault. Three, the other side from me, by the railroad. Should be possible to avoid the worst of it that way, but I won't be able to cover you.
All right, thanks.
Don't shoot and don't get too close. We don't want them to know we're here until we want them to know we're here.
Okay, you're the expert in springing attacks on the unsuspecting.
I'm meeting them head on. Direct assault.
Hey, I'm gonna get in position.
Hey, I got a good vantage. I'll see what I can do up here when the time comes.
I reckon our best shot is coming at them from two different directions.
All right, I'll take that on board.
On your signal.
All right, let's do this.
Laying down fire!
Here I come, assholes!
Hey, hey! Some motherfuckers is rolling on us!
Shit!
Be gone!
Thank you. go before they turn you into wood chip.
Oh, crazy dude! Hey, homie!
Yeah. Get up. Let's go.
There's more of them coming! Run, Mark! Move it, guys! Come on!
Oh, Frank's here too! Hey, Frank!
You thought T came by himself? Come on, man!
Man, this shit looks like overkill!
Hey, let's stay this side where Michael can cover!
Cut your losses! Let us go!
This guy's up on the side there!
We're getting out of here!
Get a proper introduction, dog.
we getting out of here, man. Let's go!
Shit, homie. You all right?
I'm straight, homie. Bitches got the jump on me, though.
How'd they get you to come all the way out here?
Man, I ain't finna let a little drive stand in the way of a money-making opportunity.
Or a get-killed opportunity.
Man, you always a pessimist.
Nah, nigga. A realist. Cause in reality...
Fuck, man!
All them fools wanna clap your ass.
Man, what a trust that, dawg. I peeped out that wood chopping place when he was up this way on that Devin Weston car lit, which I still ain't been paid for, incidentally. All secluded and shit. Stretch hit me up, I'm like, yeah, that's the perfect place to buy Kush by the missing.
Nigga, perfect place to clap some fool you beefing with.
Man, I ain't even know at the time. I just thought we was gonna parlay.
Parlay? Nigga, please. Every time you leave the house, fools try to clap you. Every meet you set up, homies there for the express purpose of clapping your ass.
Man, you sure? Because I'm sure there's been a few times when...
No. I'm completely 100% sure. Every time, nigga. Whether you buying drugs, selling drugs, or discussing drugs, talking about the weather, whatever.
Man, these streets is hard, dawg. This the hood you talking about. Maybe you forgot, since you've been bettering yourself, sitting in that house on the hill, looking down on the animals in South Central and shit.
Man, you know it ain't like that.
Do I, my nigga? Because that's the way it looked to me. I'm making the best out of what I'm giving. You know what I'm talking about? I ain't in some type of mentorship program. The only mentor I got...
And we gonna do something about that, dawg. Trust me.
Man, I ain't got people teaching me that white-collar crime shit. Ain't shit changed for me, and you ain't helping.
Ain't helping? What the fuck you call this? Me, Michael, Trevor, we all came up here to help.
The unholy fucking trinity. Ballers beware when these fools rolling together.
You jealous of Michael and Trevor?
What happened to me and you fucking shit up? Form gangsters, nigga.
So I shouldn't have called him, right? Man, I was doing everything in my power to make sure you wasn't clapped.
I can make sure I ain't clapped.
Clearly you can't.
Next time, homie, don't come. And matter of fact, if you do come, don't bring them dudes.
Man, look, let's not talk next time. Next time, don't get your ass in the situation, all right?
It's the hood, Frank. That's what happens in the hood.
No the fuck it don't. Not for everyone.
I'm one of them dudes that it happens to.
Man, you gonna tell me what was going on back then?
Hood shit, homie. That's the shit that's different from the country club shit your overpaid ass is presently accustomed to.
Man, stress put us on this shit, man. Man, we gonna get on his ass.
Man, fuck that, homie. Look like I give a shit.
Nigga, I give a shit.
Stress do what he do. Niggas want me dead, be dead themselves. I ain't gonna overreact to shit.
Overreact? Man, that nigga Stress tried to get you killed, nigga.
Nigga, that's the hood. I'm still here, ain't I?
Just.
You sure Stress knew they was gonna book me?
Yeah, nigga, Stress knew. Everybody knew Stress knew. Tanisha knew Stress knew, and she don't even come around the fucking hood no more.
Damn, that nigga Stress janky like that?
Man, you don't see this? Man, Stress been screwing us from the start.
Like from back in the day?
From like the other day, dawg. Since after we went to the recycling place and D and them ballers try to take us down.
But Stretch put in the work on D.
Yeah, man, that's survival. Remember how angry his ass got? Especially with you bringing him into this shit?
Aye, but tell me this, though. If Stretch was fucking with your boy LD, why he set us up with the deal for the brick in the first place? He go off and make peace with the ballers, come back, and then put us on the lick on Grove Street.
Man, you remember Grove Street? That brick was drywall. Ripping us off was probably Stretch's ideal anyway.
Damn, you think so?
It makes sense, don't it?
Man, I ain't knowing, man, maybe.
Man, Stress got in with the ballers when he... When he was inside. Played us as marks, dawg, but a bunch of them got booked. So now they gotta come back at us. So Stress sends you out there where they doing the Kush deal.
Then you show up and save the day.
Yeah, thankfully.
Man, it wouldn't even be the same if your boy LD wasn't out here getting in the shit. And FC wasn't getting him out of it. Know what I'm talking about?
Man, I don't know.
That shit was fun, nigga. Don't tell me you didn't enjoy scrapping like we did back in the day.
It ain't back in the day no more, dawg.
But it felt like it was.
Okay, fool. It was fun saving your useless ass one more fucking time.
There you go. That wasn't too hard.
You should have seen your face when I came in. You was like, shit. Hey, shit, man.
Oh, bullshit, nigga.
You better check them drawers, homie. You probably shitted yourself.
Fuck you, man. I don't care if I die. It's a compliment if they sending an army after a nigga. They only send like two of the little homies to get you.
Nigga, you didn't look like they was paying you no compliment, nigga.
Must have just caught a glimpse of your ugly ass.
Nigga, you think I'm some angel come to take your ass somewhere you never going to.
You pray to your white man God, homie. I'm going to the great plain beyond where the buffalo keep on roaming and the little squaw bitches want me to nut on their face all day.
Bitch, please.
So I guess what we learned is, nigga, don't think it ain't no fun to be half fucking with the homies, nigga. You feel me, my nigga?
Yeah, I guess you can look at it like that.
Hey, but on some real shit, my nigga, you know your nigga out here doing BAD, man. Why don't you slide me a few dollars or something? You know what I'm talking about? It's hard out here in the set.
Oh, shit, my nigga, that's nothing. Shit,
nigga, I know you done went all Illuminati and shit, you know what I'm saying, leaving the street niggas in the back, but damn, man, way to keep a nigga down, my nigga. I mean, thank you. I guess it's payment for all the work a nigga put in for you getting them cars and shit, you know what I'm talking about? Give a nigga just enough money to get him a little 40 ounce in a bucket of chicken on the way to the pole house, huh?
Man, don't be like that, dawg. Because number one, I never got paid for them motherfucking cars. Number two, I saved your motherfucking ass. No matter how many times you and that tiny motherfucking brain of yours to try to get us killed, I saved you, dawg.
Man, you supposed to, my nigga. I thought we was homies for life.
Me too, but I thought we was trying to get out of this bullshit. You live in a fantasy, homie. The best thing you can hope for is a big turnout for your motherfucking funeral.
Nigga, ain't nobody coming to your funeral.
What? Man, what about all the motherfucking times I saved your life, homie? What about that?
Oh, thank you, homie. Thanks for leaving your nigga in the backfield.
You know what, my nigga? If your ass can just act civilized, you would get some work. But instead, you want to be this gang-banging, mad-dogging asshole.
Oh, my bad, Mr. Goldcard. Excuse me, sir. Thank you for helping out a post-street nigga like me, sir. You can go now, sir. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Nigga, who you think I am, nigga?
Oh, fuck you, Lamar.
Nah, fuck you, F, nigga. I thought we was homies, nigga. But that's some shit that just got past you, my nigga.
You know what, dawg? If something good comes up, I hit my dude, man. Chill out, all right?
Yeah, whatever, nigga. You just hit me when you find out what the true concept of friendship is, nigga. We came from the sandbox together.
I know that. I got you, dog. If something good come up, I got you.
Yeah, whatever, nigga. I'm in the turf, nigga, if you remember where that is.
Oh! What's up, playa?
Hello, Franklin.
Man, I don't know y'all. We done,
hey,
man.
We ain't done yet, homie. Not yet.
Nearly.
Man, what the fuck y'all want me to do? Kill the president? Fuck his wife or something? Or invade some fucking country?
No, no. Something more sensible.
Something that's gotta be done.
Hey. When the timing's right, you're gonna take old Trevor and put him out to pasture, homie.
Michael will be sensible, but Trevor won't be.
Trevor is a liability that none of us can afford.
Man, Trevor saved you. He saved both of y'all asses.
And it's unfortunate.
Hey, when we give you the word, you're gonna do this thing.
Man, get Michael to do it. Me and Trevor cool, dawg.
Michael can't do it. Trevor won't let him near.
That's why it's up to you, homie.
Hey, who was that?
Nobody. Don't worry about it, nigga.
Hey, oh, flossing ass nigga.
Franklin?